Hello and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Wednesday, March 9th, 2016 by Gaia Blooming. I'm Mimi and our energy mantra for today is beauty unfolds in this moment. And I could actually decide between beauty unfolds in this moment and beauty unfolds as this moment. So we're actually getting both beauty unfolds in this moment and beauty unfolds as this moment. And we're coming down today from huge, amazing eclipse energy with the new moon solar eclipse in Pisces last evening. Actually, as I record this, we're still building into the eclipse. So there's still a lot of lessons that are processing at this time. But I really feel like our dreams after this eclipse with the moon finishing up in Pisces are going to give way to more information, more light, more confirmation, more work for us to move through and unfold through with the eclipse in Pisces. And we're down one eclipse for this part of eclipse season in this year, and we're building into another one with the full moon in 2.5 weeks. So while the wheels are turning, the motion is so far from finished. And it's really interesting because the moon is going to shift into Aries today. It's going to shift late morning, early afternoon. And the shift is so interesting. The morning's probably going to feel really quiet, a lot of processing in. And the shift into Aries usually is one where we want to take action, especially with the moon in Aries connecting via trine, which is a really easy, happy connection to Mars and Sagittarius. These two fire signs, these two fire energies really want to move us. And I got so many interesting messages around here. I was like, how do I find the balance in this message? There was a message about not being complacent in this energy. Don't let just the knowledge that's come through, the wisdom that's come through, these lessons that have come through, don't be satisfied with just the knowledge. There is going to be action that's going to be necessary, but at the same time, don't just move impulsively due to the fact that you feel like you need to act. Let yourself be moved from a place that's deeper, a deeper knowledge of knowing how to act. So it's finding that balance of not being complacent and not being just stuck here with this and actually bringing it into the body and embodying it, but at the same time, not rushing in the way the Aries Mars energy wants to dive in right now. Everything must be now. I have been working through lessons of patience, and it's really funny because in my dreams last night, I had a lot of cat energy come through, and as I was going down the animal medicine rabbit hole, I came across tiger, because tiger is one of my power animals, and as I found a new site, I was like, what did they say about tiger? And with tiger energy, and I think this is true with all cats, patience is the golden key. That's what it said. And I was like, ding. And funny enough, one of the cards that I pulled today is the card tiger, the success card. Patience is the golden key. Knowing when to act, knowing how to act, not being stuck here in the action, but really letting your body, which this eclipse had major body lessons for us, body information for us, letting our body kind of pull us into the movement rather going head first, Aries style, right into the action. And pay attention to how cats do that. Cats, when they're about to pounce, they sit there, they study, they watch their prey because, you know, it's their survival. And they know often they have, you know, one chance to get it right. And I think we have more than one chance to get it right. I've been shown in my life we have more than one chance to get it right. But pay attention to those instincts that are within you. As we're coming out of this eclipse, we're still, you know, deep in Pisces land, Pisces energy, letting the energy of releasing resistance be a big part of how we're taking action. So your action may just be, again, the internal work of recognizing where you're resistant to acting. And so you're not supposed to act, because if you act with resistance, you're not going to be all in. So really pay attention to that today. We're building to two things too, which is really going to be, I think, interesting and maybe bring some more keys through from this eclipse. We're building to Chiron conjunct the Sun tomorrow and Mercury conjunct Neptune tomorrow. So in that energy, we get may get some more downloads, some more information that'll show us the whole picture, that'll show us how to move. But for now, allow your momentum, your movement to be an unfolding. Patience is the golden key, and that's how you reach success. The other card I pulled is conditioning, and I think that's kind of how we are. We're either in like wait, back off mode, or we're in like full forward drive. So I think this is part of the conditioning to be like, I'm engaged with my process, like a cat is as it's stalking something. I'm engaged, I'm in action in that way, but I'm not going to move until that force within me is like, and now. And the other card I pulled is past lives. Pay attention to your dreams. I'm getting so many dream messages coming through. These past life patterns are showing up. These past life patterns that may be holding you in this place of conditioning, that are holding you back from really leaping where you want to leap. So pay attention to any patterns. If you don't recognize them as past life, if they seem very this life pattern, that's okay too. Wherever these patterns are showing up, pay attention to them. And in the spirit of release with this big eclipse, the Rumi for today, don't grieve. Anything you lose comes around in another form. God's joy moves from unmarked box to unmarked box, from cell to cell, as rainwater down into flower bed, as roses up from the ground. It hides within these till one day it cracks them open. So that is it for today. Book a reading if you'd like to go deeper into your chart and look at how you can move. And I will see you tomorrow. Namaste.